Would you rather sit around watching D-News videos all day instead of exercising? Well, if so, scientific research suggests that your genes might be to blame. Hi, I'm Kristen Conger of Stuff Mom Never Told You for D-News. And in 2013, research on genes, or the cellular instruction manuals we inherit from our parents, offered some fascinating insights into how those nifty DNA packages may influence our daily habits and behaviors. For starters, researchers out of the University of Missouri pinpointed a set of 36 genes that might determine how much or little we love to exercise. After noticing how some lab rats voluntarily jogged on their wheels while others took it easy inside their cages, the researchers bred 10 generations of the active and not so active rats and found that the physical activity gap persisted between those groups of great, 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 and so forth rat grandchildren. And the most noticeable difference between those two groups? Those 36 laziness genes. Now, in the future, though, we might have a workaround to those so-called laziness genes thanks to PLIN2, better known as the obesity gene. A promising study published in early 2013 detailed how turning off that PLIN2 genetic expression halted weight gain and increased activity levels in rats, even when they were being fed high-fat diets. Next up, scientists plan to figure out the physiological mechanisms behind that obesity gene and how it might work in humans. Now, recent digging into our DNA has revealed not only insights into our physical health, but also our emotional health. For the first time in 2013, researchers from UC Berkeley and Northwestern University identified a gene variant, or allele, that appeared to mediate husbands' and wives' emotional sensitivity to relationship ups and downs. Specifically, the people who inherited two short versions of this marital bliss gene tended to report more relationship highs and lows, whereas those with long versions of the genes were more even-keeled over the long term. Now, undoubtedly, some couples with kids may experience more emotional highs and lows due to a newly discovered gene that triggers early or precocious puberty. According to a 2013 study published in the New England Journal of Medicine, a genetic mutation passed along by fathers may cause reproductive hormones to activate in kids younger than 9 years old, which can lead to health complications later in life, not to mention a prolonged period of hormone-related adolescent angst. And finally, as a rare southpaw, I was interested to learn about a possible genetic explanation for handedness. It turns out that right-handedness, at least, may root back to embryonic genes that organize our organs and help our bodies develop symmetrically. But unfortunately, we'll have to wait until 2014 or later to get to the bottom of why some of us go left instead of right. But enough about me, what about you? What kinds of DNA discoveries are you hoping to see in the future? Tell me in the comments below and be sure to check out my channel, youtube.com/stuffmomnevertoldyou, and be sure to subscribe here for more D-News.